Hello children, good morning. Welcome back to the next video of English Literature class. Hope you are fine there. Well, it's time to start today's class. Are you ready to start today's class? Okay, before starting our class, as usual, let's have a silent prayer. So students, do you remember what we have learned in the last class? Yes, we have discussed and finish the workbook activities from the first chapter, Ice Cream Man, and I gave you a follow-up activity which is also from the workbook, and I hope you have done it properly. And there is one more activity pending in the first chapter's workbook, and that is about the activities which we are prepared to do during summer season, monsoon season, winter season, spring season. We have already done a similar activity in your textbook. Do you remember that? We discussed about what are the different activities which you prefer to do during winter and summer season, and then we classified that activities into indoor and outdoor activities. Likewise, here also, in page number 7 of your workbook, there is an activity related to the finding out of different activities which you are preferred to do during winter season, summer season, monsoon season, spring season. I know you are very familiar with these seasons, and there is another subpart for that activity. You have to list out what you do not like to do during that season. Then there is another part, you have to classify all the favorite activities into indoor and outdoor activities. Okay, so I hope you got the idea. Well, without wasting much time, we are moving to today's class, discussion of second chapter, Wonderful Ways. And take your workbook and pencil with you and try to do the workbook activities along with my class. Okay. So here we go. Wonderful Ways. So what's the first activity? Yes. Based on your reading of Wonderful Ways, answer the following questions briefly. Based on your reading of Wonderful Ways, answer the following questions briefly. So the question is, what are you going to do with those vegetable scraps? This is a dialogue from your story, Wonderful Ways. And you have to answer, who said this dialogue to whom? Do you remember the story? The story is about the making of, or the origin of, avial, one of the favorite dishes in Kerala feast. And it's very clear that this dish happened only because of the king of Travancore, or the Maharaja of Travancore, and he advised, or he ordered the cook to make use of all the vegetable scraps, and the cook thought very wisely and he made a wonderful dish, right? So these are the dialogues. What are you going to do with those vegetable scraps? We will throw them away, find a way to use them. So you have to write down who said these dialogues to whom. So let's discuss the answers. So the first dialogue, what was the first dialogue? What are you going to do with those vegetable scraps? So who said to whom? Maharaja said to cook, right? So next dialogue, we will throw them away. We will throw them away. Who said to whom? Yes, the cook said to Maharaja. The cook said to Maharaja, and Third dialogue, find a way to use them. Find a way to use them. Who said to whom? It's very clear. Maharaja said to cook. Right? I hope you got the answers. Try to write it down in your workbook. Just look at the video and try to write down in your workbook this time. Okay. So the answers, once again, Maharaja to cook, cook to Maharaja, Maharaja to cook. Okay. I hope you have done it. And moving to the next activity, B. Based on your reading of Wonderful Waste, answer the following. It's very clear. We have to answer certain questions. Shall we start? Okay, here we go. So the first question, to which place did the Maharaja belong? To which place did the Maharaja belong? The question is very clear. So the answer is, I hope you already got the answer. Let's see the answer. Maharaja belonged to the kingdom of Travancore. The kingdom of Travancore is very famous in our Kerala, right? So, Maharaja belonged to the kingdom of Travancore. Okay? I hope you have write it in your workbook. And moving to the next question. What did the cook add to the cooking vegetables? What did the cook add to the cooking vegetables? Already we discussed about the ingredients of avial in our story. And we also discussed about sambar. Do you remember that follow-up activity? There is an activity in your textbook regarding another dish consisted of so many vegetables. And most of the students answered that sambar is that another dish. And here you have to mention the ingredients of avial. So already the cooking vegetables are mentioned here, and we need to mention the rest of the ingredients. So here is the answer. Cook added the paste of fresh coconut, green chilies and garlic, salt, curd, coconut oil and curry leaves. Do you remember? The cook started to cut all the vegetable scraps into pieces and put all the vegetable scraps in a pot. And then he ground some fresh coconut and he made a paste from that fresh coconut, green chilies and garlic. Then he added salt, curd, coconut oil and finally decorated with curry leaves. So these are the ingredients of the avial. Okay. So this is the answer. We are moving to the next question. What smell came from the pot? What smell came from the pot? The kind of smell is described in that story. Do you remember that? A dash smell came out from the pot. Let's see the answer. A tempting smell came from the pot. A tempting smell came from the pot. So the answer is a tempting smell came from the pot. Write down in your workbook. Try to write down all the works along with this class itself. That's why I am mentioning you that you need to take your workbook and pencil while you are attending this class. Okay. So moving to the next. How did the cook decorate the curry? We have already discussed that. How did the cook decorate the curry? Simple answer. Let's see the answer. The cook decorated the curry with curry leaves. The cook decorated the curry with curry leaves. Okay, very simple question and answer. Try to recollect the story also. And if you have any difficulties, just read the story once more. Okay. Moving to the next question. What was everyone eager about? What was everyone eager about? We already found that the cook served this dish to all the guests and everyone was very eager to know what. Let's see the answer. Everyone was eager to know the name of the dish. Am I right? Everyone was eager to know the name of the dish. Okay. Then, what's this follow-up activity? You are wondering that there is one more question there, right? Then why did Ebin sir showing this follow-up activity? There is a reason behind that. Yes, you have to answer the sixth question yourself. So that's the follow-up activity of today's class. So the question is, what became famous all over Kerala? Question is, what became famous all over Kerala? It's very simple. Okay, try to do it yourself and don't forget to do the workbook activity from the first chapter, Ice Cream Man, page number 7, about the activities of winter, monsoon, spring, summer seasons, right? Okay, so today I am giving you two activities for you. First one is the activity from the page number 7 in your workbook, and the second thing is the 6 questions answer. So you have to do it properly at your home. Well, it's time to say goodbye for you. So we will see you in the next class. Thanks for watching. Stay safe at your home. Thank you.